Good morning, dear children. Welcome back to e-class of Max. We are starting our fifth chapter. In this chapter, we are studying something differently from all the chapters till now we have handled. We are going to study about some data handling. The chapter for data handling. Then what is meant by this data handling? For that, first of all, we have to check what is data. You have heard the name, the term data, while we are using this computer, isn't it? Then what is this data? Data is some information. Data is some information that we collect about an event, anything that numerically represents some things, some quantities, some values. These all are data. Here we are dealing with all these types of data and how we are handling this, how we are representing this. These are things we are going to study in this chapter. Actually, this chapter is a very simple chapter and very interesting chapter also. Okay, first of all, we are discussing about data. Data, what is the data? The information collected is called data. Any information collected is known as data. For example, we can say about a cricket match. Then one of the player one got 50 runs. 50 runs in one match. Player two got 23 runs. Then one another player got 78 runs. Then one another player got 11 runs. Then these are all numerical data, but we are seeing it as in the form of player 1, player 2, this got 50 runs, 23 runs, such like we are having this information. These are all information. Then how we are going to represent this? How can all we represent these? All the data. That means we can represent in different manners. First of all, we can use the name. First one is pictograph. Have you heard about pictograph? It is the basic thing that you are studying from UKG to LKG. That thing, what it is? It is the pictograph. What is pictograph? We are representing the data graphically. Graphically means we are representing it using figures, rectangles, triangles. These are things are representing graphically. That means with image, with graphs we are representing the data. Then that thing we are having to study in this chapter known as data handling. Our first topic, that is pictograph. What is pictograph? That is a very simple that it represents by pictures. What is the thing that is represented by pictures? And there should be a scale. What is a scale? That means, for example, here you can see that it is a picture of a flower. Then one flower indicates that there are 10 flowers. One flower means 10 flowers. Then this is the list of the flowers got on each day, Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday for a gardener. Then that means Monday he have 1, 2, 3. Is that it is three number of flowers there he had got? No. Then one flower represent, that is equal to 10 flowers. Then how many flowers are this? 10 flowers. This is 10 flowers and this is 10 flowers. Then how much will he get? 10 plus 10 plus 10, that is 30. 30 flowers he have got on Monday. Such like we are representing the data in the form of pictures. sometimes it will be one flower only, or one picture of a car, one picture of a pen. Then that if there is given that one picture is equal to 10, 5, 100, anything, that means there is a scale. If there is not given any scale, then how many number of pictures are given, then we have to correct it. We want to count it and write the numbers, isn't it? Okay, then it is a graph, pictograph. Then from this, how can we understood the data? How can we interpret that data? Okay, first of one, there is a question, how many flowers got on Tuesday? On Tuesday, how many flowers we have got? Tuesday, there is a picture of one flower. What does it mean? One flower means that is equal to 10 flowers, isn't it? Then how many flowers he got on Tuesday? That is equal to 10, isn't it? He has got 10 number of flowers. He has got 10 number of flowers. Then how many flowers got in Wednesday? How many flowers he have got in Wednesday? Here you can see that it is Wednesday here, and then 1, 2. Is it just 3 full? No, it is not 3 full, and it is half of a flower, isn't it? What does it mean? A full flower means 10 flower. Then half a flower means it will be 5 flowers. 10 by 2, isn't it? That means there are only 5 flowers. We can count it 1, 2, 2 and a half, isn't it? Then 2.5 into 10, you will get 25 flowers. Then how many flowers got in Wednesday? That is equal to 25 flowers. Okay, have you understood? Then any of the picture is given in the half portion, that means the scale divided by 2 is okay. Then in which day he got maximum and minimum number of flowers? On which days he have got the maximum number of flowers? Then for that, first of all, we have going to count the number of flowers got on each day. On Monday, we have got 1, 2 and 3. 3 into 10, that is 30 number of flowers he have got on Monday. Then here, only one flower, that means 10 flowers he have got on Tuesday. Then Wednesday, how many flowers? 1, 2 and a half. That is 25 flowers he have got on Wednesday. Which is the largest number, maximum number? That is on Monday he have got maximum. Monday he have got maximum number of flowers on Monday. Maximum. Then on minimum, on which day? Again we are going to count. It is 30 is maximum. Then here is only 1 flower and here is 2.5 flowers. That means 1 flower, that is equal to 10 flower, and it is on Tuesday. Tuesday he has got minimum. Okay, then this is the way how we can interpret data from a pictograph and how we should understand a pictograph. Hope you have cleared the topic.
Next, we are studying about the next type of representation of data, that is bar graph and double bar graph. Single bar graph and double bar graph. Then what is this bar graph? We are representing the information, that means data, in the form of bars. You can see here, this is a bar graph and this is double bar graph. You can see that here it is given that these are subjects. These are subjects and these are marks. Marks. Here, these are subjects and these are marks. Okay. Then, in this axis, it is given subject, English, Hindi, Science and Maths. This is the mark scored by a student in
have got that. This is the marks got by a student for the semester 1 exam. He have got 14 marks in English. How can we understand that he have got 14 marks in English? From this bar graph, we are interpreting the data by either drawing a rough line to this way and this. You can draw this way and got the marks of 4 English. It is represented by a bar of same width. Here it is, isn't it? At a uniform displacement, uniform distances, we are having represented each of the subjects with bars. These are bars of same width. These all widths are same and only difference in height. That means height shows the marks scored for each subject. Here you can see that it is English subject. In English we have got 14 marks. How can we got that 14 marks? We can draw a line with the help of a scale. Then a rough line, don't make it hard line. Then from that we can get that it is 40 marks. Then for Hindi, how much he have got? Again draw a small line, then that is 30. Then we have got for English in semester 1 we have got 40 marks. For Hindi we have got 30 marks. For science we have got how much? This is the marks we have got for science. That is in between of 40 and 50. In between of 40 and 50, it is the bisecting one. Then we can write it as 45 marks. Then English, it is 40. Then Hindi, it is 30. And for science we have got 45. And in maths, now you can say that how many marks you have got in maths? How can we study? Just draw a line such like, and here it is again 40 marks. Then these are the marks scored for the semester 1 for one student for 1, 2, 3 and 4 subjects. 4 subjects are there and these are the marks scored by him for the semester 1. Then this is the way how we are representing the data through a single bar graph. Okay. Then next we are going to study about double bar graph. A single bar graph and a double bar graph are linked together. That means we are representing the same way. Then here you can see that one English have 2 bars. Then what is this 2 bars? It will be given out of the graph. That is, this blank bar indicates semester 1. It is the mark that he got in semester 1. Blank one. This one. This one. This one. And this one. Then next one. This is the line that is shaded. Portion is semester 2 marks. That means for it is given the marks for 4 subjects, English, Hindi, Science and Maths. Then these are the 4 subjects marks that he have got for semester 1 and semester 2. From that we can compare his mark for each subject in semester 1 and 2. What improvement he have done, what happened to his studies, if it is increased or decreased. These all things can be comparison with this help of double bar graph. Again, there is only difference in the height, no difference in the width, and they are equally displaced also. Then here we can check how we can interpret the values that are same as the earlier. For English, the marks for this one, it is 40. For semester 1, it is English, it is 40. Then for English, for semester 2, what is his marks? It is 35. English, it is 35. Then we can check whether it is an increase or decrease. Of course, he has decreased, isn't it? Then compare the marks of semester 1 and semester 2 of each subject. And then next one to Hindi. What is the result? Then it is from here to here it is 30. Then for semester 1 Hindi it was 30 marks. And for semester 2 what is this mark? It is 40. It is 40. Then for science it is 45 was for the first semester. 45 was the first mark. And for the next semester, what is the mark? It is 40. Semester 2, science it is 40. Then for math, what is the mark? For the first semester, it was 35. Max. 35. And for the second semester, what's the marks? It is 40. Then, here we have interpreted the data from double bar graph. It is for English, we have got for semester 1, 40 marks, and for English in semester 2, it is 35. He have decreased the marks, isn't it? Then for Hindi, it was 30 earlier and then it is 40, isn't it? That means he have got increased in studies for 10 marks. Then next one for science, it was 45 at first semester and second semester he have got 5 marks less. Then for math, it is 35 for first semester and 40 marks for second semester. That means he increased the marks for 5 marks for second semester. From all together, we can understand that he has some improvement also and some decrease also for his marks, isn't it? Then how we can analyze the marks with the help of a double bar graph? Now you should understand. Then all clear with the both bar graph and double bar graph. What is the difference between bar graph and double bar graph? We can only analyze the given thing and there is no comparison with same. English cannot be comparison with English for last semester, first semester. This is not happened for a bar graph, single bar graph. But it can be done for double bar graph. It is the difference and it is the benefit of the double bar graph.